get back to the guy called Brent Elliott, who made the artwork.
Yes.
He worked, of course, with Megadeth and Death Angel.
Yes.
He made the last Death Angel.
Yes, cover, and he did the Job for a Cowboy cover. That's the one that we really liked.
So you send him the painting, but
basically what we sent him, yeah, we sent him the painting. We said what we wanted.
The lyrics also.
Yeah, the lyrics. We sent him. We told him that what kind of image we wanted on the cover. We want to have a strong leading group. We wanted burning cities in the background. We want to have the arch enemy symbol in there somehow. We want to have black flags because we're transporting an atheist anarchist message, and he made it like, and he obviously composed. He put that into life, but. I love it. It's very detailed. When you can really, like, I've got the high-res version, you can really zoom in, you can see all the little things on the skin and lots of stuff happening background.
I will tonight.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's like, I'd like to see it once hanging in a massive blow-up printout at I don't know, maybe in the Berlin where the Reich, you know, where our government building is. It's massive, so you should be hanging it down there. Pretty awesome.
Because you have lived in Germany, and of course you have known the wall, the Berlin Wall.
Yeah, of course. So I was part of that because
Is it why you put in on a message of revolution?
I mean, obviously that's part of my history. I've the main guy of my previous bands. He is from Eastern Germany. My father, his family fled from Eastern Germany. They did the whole going over the wall in the night thing. Leaving everything behind. It's obviously a strong part of my history.
How old were you when the wall fell down?
When was that? 90? Was it? When was that? 95, 96? When did they came down? I can't even actually remember. But I was like, early 20s. Very, you know, that's when you really. That's the right time, I think, for revolution. You get very impressed by stuff like that, and it changes your political outlook. And it was awesome just actually to be able to visit all the friends we had, all the metal friends we had over there. Just being, because we did it before, but we always had to stop at the border, and that was that's when we could just drive through. So that was pretty awesome. When the wall came down. But there's many walls left in the world, you know, they're coming down now. Most of them are invisible, but they're just as real.
And you have traveled all over the world, so you know where.
Yeah, and
where
we know.
Some fire on stage.
Yeah, where people tell us, like, we've played in lots of Islamic countries now, or like China, we're being told maybe you shouldn't be performing that song, like Revolution Begins and We Will Rise, not the popular ones, like fuck it. And we played Revolution Begins, and I remember when we were on stage in China, Beijing, and I had a little revolution speech before that. And they always have people there, government people with guns standing there. And they were just like looking at each other. They didn't really know how to react. And I had to full on let the revolution begin and fuck all these barriers. And then had all the people coming from the back, were held down by barriers. They all crashing the barriers and coming up front. And these policemen with their guns, they didn't know what to do. And then they stepped to the side and let it just happen. Mm. So that was pretty awesome. But it was a bit playing with fire. It could have got, maybe, I don't know. I don't think it can go wrong because the government, the Chinese, especially Chinese governments, there's so much. The world is staring at them, you know. So that's why you can do stuff like that. Rattling the chains, shaking the gates. Lead a war cry, let there be no doubt. We want out.
There's a reckoning. Reminded that a lot of great speed passages and very melodic solos. Also, tracked by Ricard.
Yes.
Bengtsson.
Yes.
So he recorded the Doomsday Machine.
Yes.
Album.
I mean, Rickard's just.
What was his role, actually?
Yeah. He's just a dude who owns quite a big studio in Halmstad. And he's actually been singing on one of Christopher Amott's Armageddon records. So he understands metal music, which is, I think, it's important because that's what we are. We are 100% metal, so you need to get it. But what he also brings in is a little bit of the melodic he comes from a melodic metal vocal approach, which I like, because I feel that a lot of death metal bands or death metal singers, I don't like the monotonous death metal style. I'm very influenced by Chuck Schuldiner, who's been very melodic in his extreme vocal style, and that's where I wanted to go. And I like the Schlager approach to the Schlager hit parade approach to death metal vocals, because I want to make them accessible. I want people to actually listen to the music and understand words and get the vibe, as opposed to just be a blunt force instrument vocally. But I mean, tracking wise, we've pretty much done it all ourselves. Charlie actually tracked all the guitars and the solos, all the rhythm guitars and the solos. Daniel tracked a shitload of stuff. Charlie tracked Daniel. So we have been tracking, Chris tracked guitars. We've been tracking each other. And what the only role Richard Bengtsson played there is sending the sound, like the recording sound. Mm. So you got something to record with. And that was that. And the rest we just did pretty much on ourselves, because we are a band. We like to work we like to work 18-hour shifts. We like to work through the night. Nobody does that who has got a family and a life. Mm. You know, so we want to be as free. That's just our motto and credo: freedom, maximum freedom. And that goes for the work, the style of work, or how we record as well.
Which was not really the case for the two previous albums.
No, I hated Rise of the Tyrant.
Yeah.
Don't like the sound nowadays. Been very confined to other people's studio hours.
Yeah.
And you know, people come from in and they finish at 6 p.m. and we're like, well, but we're just bored. I mean, what are we gonna? You're sitting in the nowhere in the middle of Sweden. All you can actually do is work, and that's all we wanted. So that's what we did this time again. Like, we basically just rented this place and just went nuts in it and did our own thing.
So as an artist, you try to search freedom always.
Always in every aspect. We're self-managed, self-booked, self-maintained, self-recorded, self-produced. We do our artwork ourselves, everything is done. We are like a little bit autonomous little cell, you know. And in case the world fucking goes to hell, I think we can still survive.
You have understood it. It's a do-it-yourself album.
Yes.
It's not made in a cave. Huh?
No.
It's a really great...